Reading a Skew-T diagram. What is a Skew-T diagram? Skew-T diagram is used to forecast weather for a single day for a certain location. It shows an instantaneous snapshot of the atmosphere from the surface to about 100 millibars up through the atmosphere. How are these readings taken? These readings are taken using radio sondes, also known as weather balloons, which are sent throughout the atmosphere at 0Z and 12Z at thousands of locations across the world. Instruments on the balloons will gather data and transmit it back to the surface, where graphs, such as the Skew-T diagram, are made. Data that is gathered include temperature, humidity, dew point, wind speed, and wind direction. Let's go through the different parts of a Skew-T diagram. First, let's look at the temperature isotherms. In the image to the left, you can see lines that trend from the southwest corner of the image to the northeast corner. These are the temperature isotherms. In this image, they are highlighted in black. Increments for temperature are given every 10 degrees Celsius, and they are labeled, as you can see, along the right side of the diagram. In this image here, highlighted in blue, you will see pressure isobars. As we learned several chapters ago, isobars are lines of equal pressure. On a Skew-T, they will run horizontally from left to right and will be labeled along the left side of the diagram in increments of 100 millibars. Now, you may be wondering, on the images we just saw, there was no data. What does it look like once we have data? Well, you will see on this image here, the wind speed and the wind direction plotted along the right side of the diagram. You'll also see a red line and a green line. In the next two slides, we will go over what the green line and the red lines mean. But first, let me go over where we find the surface. If we look at the very bottom of the chart, around 1,000 millibars in this image, we see that the data begins to be charted. This is where we find the surface. Now let's go over the different components of the graph. The red line that we see here is the environmental temperature, charted from the surface to approximately 0 millibars. The environmental sounding, also known as the air temperature, is basically what the temperature is as we go through the atmosphere. This line will run south to north, with the surface being at the bottom. You will always notice that the red line is to the right of the green line. This is because temperature is always greater than or equal to the dew point. Now, let's look at the green line. The green line is the dew point temperature. We will find this always to the left of the red line. This line also runs from south to north, beginning at the surface and decreasing as we move up the atmosphere. On this last slide here, we see the final component of a Skew-T diagram, this being wind speed and wind direction. Wind speed is charted from the surface to 0 millibars. It is read in the same manner as we learned several chapters ago, where a short stick is 5 knots, one long stick is 10 knots, a combination of a short stick and a long stick is 15 knots, increasing as we go up. You also want to remember, when looking at a wind barb, how we read wind direction. Wind direction is given as the direction that the wind is coming from. So, in this image here, we see one long pennant, one long stick, two long sticks, and one short stick. And also, this stick is pointing to the southeast. If we want to know how to read this, we're going to look at the end, or the flag, or the pennant, and the sticks are. We don't want to look at the end where there's no information. We want to look down here, where everything is charted. So if we look here, we see that in this image here, the wind is actually coming from the southeast and moving to the northwest. And since we see one pennant, two long flags, and a short flag, we jump back to our little table here. We see an open flag is 50 knots, two long sticks, is 20 knots, and one short stick is 5 knots. So if we add it all up, 50 plus 20 plus 5 will come to a wind speed of 75 knots. Students, this is the simple introduction on how to read a Skew-T diagram. Now, if you will jump over to your week 7 questions, you will see that we put this into practice.